the same floor, and they were able to beat them. So they're up 2-1 in the series, but now a lot of pressure, sort of like how Champlain was. A lot of pressure on St. Foy because they're supposed to move on.
Well, the first course of your feast was very fulfilling. Will the second game now equal that level of excitement that we had? A low-scoring affair, but we talk about these two teams and how well they've been so far this year. Both scoring points in the 60-plus range. So we anticipate that will be the same scenario, that we might see a higher output of points than what we saw in game number one today.
Yeah, we might see a higher output, but if I'm coach from St. Foy, you got to watch out for Catherine Oliver. She's going to be taking shots, but she's going to take 10, 20, 30, as many as she can. So you got to watch out for her. On the other side, I know St. Foy's going to be playing that 1-3-1 if it gets too dicey.
And as you see now, St. Foy being welcomed into the Champlain Calderon here. It is the first game of their campaign. Winner of this game is pretty straightforward. If St. Foy were to win today, they will have another rendezvous with St. John. Champlain will play Dawson at 11 a.m. tomorrow morning. If Lennoxville were to win, that means it would be Lennoxville against Dawson and Champlain against St. John. That would be 11 o'clock.
Ladies and gentlemen, tomorrow morning. Let's get ready to rumble!
The straw that stirs a drink is the All-Star MVP.
St. Foy and Lennoxville, we're seconds away from tip-off. What do they have for us on game number two of the afternoon window here from St. Lambert? It is Lennoxville in their away blues with white numeral trim, and St. Foy in their home grays with navy and white numeral trim. And here is the MVP, the star of the show, Naoti Girard, who is now in the lower block. Quick hands by Oliver, kept the left on the toe tap, going towards the line, and that is incomplete by her, and recovered by St. Foy the other way.
Oliver, my namesake, Oliver's going to Carlton. She's a hard defender. She's a tough defender, plays hard. You're going to see her on the floor often, but she'll get back up and try to score in your face. Kofi here, she's going to call her own play. You're going to see she's going to do a lot of calling her own play here.
Kofi is smelling like coffee in that one. Had 13-7 against Lennoxville last week, made 68 field goals during the regular season, and they're off and running.
No, definitely. Like, usually St. Foy's are very structured when they play offensively, but again, Kofi's one of the players that just goes off script, and you need certain players like that.
Kung, down low, that's just a bounce off. Lennoxville's first offensive possession, and they are perfect on that one. Penelope Studhalter scoring about 8 a game. We had 18 points and 14 rebounds against St. Foy last week.
Studhalter's a tough player there.
Into traffic, stolen again by the Cougars. That's their second steal. They hit about 9 a game. Oliver now back on the front foot. And you can talk about Catherine Oliver, and she had 13 points and 5 rebounds against St. Foy. And here she is, the dynamite, explosive, and a 4-2 lead.
And that's a big matchup. Catherine Oliver against Sophie Bergeron. Sophie Bergeron is the MVP of the defensive MVP of the league right now. Defensive player of the league, right? So good matchup.
And a giveaway by Paradis, and here come the Cougars. So a big flat right now for St. Foy trying to get themselves going in this 1 p.m. game. From the corner pocket, off the side rim, that's recovered off the miss from Ismar. And here comes Garand, the Rolls Royce, showing the baby Bentley how it's done in a 4-4 game.
Baby Bentley with those pink shoes, I love it, man. Dress well, play well. Look good, play good.
We have some big hitters in this game. Oliver, Garand, and here is Ismar. Oliver from the flats. Side rim again, rebounded by St. Foy, and here comes the dynamic the other way. St. Foy, very calm in their offense, efficient, hitting about 33% of their field goals this season. Garand for three. The idea was there, the execution was not, and here comes Lennoxville the other way.
That was late in the shot clock, a shot that Garand could hit. So it's 4-4 right now. Both teams are trying each other out.
Oliver, sorry. And that was a lot of O's, but not a lot of O's on that play.
My bad there, Mo. I thought I saw a move there, but it was $1 million move, 2 cent finish, Mo.
Yeah, unfortunately, that was not the case. Coming in the game now is Angelique Marcoux along with number 9 and Anais Trempe for the first time today. 4-4 game. We are 2 minutes into this game. There is some flamboyance and flash with these teams. And this will be a foul going against Ismar. with 7:16 left in this first quarter play.
Yeah, Ismark's going to try to cover full court on that, make it hard for Giral to bring up the ball, try to disrupt their offense.
So beside out for St. Foy, here's Giral, watched by Ismark. That will be her assignment, babysitting Giral wherever she goes, step for step. Giral, back out on the give and go. Here she is for three. And the side rim, it was a good quality shot, but did not come up with the effort required at the end.
No, that's great offense there. Great quality shot there.
And Ismar back with it from the center arc. High, low, into the jungle of arms. Studhalter, and a whistle on the play on that pass come from Babin. And you talk about Penelope Studhalter scoring under 9 a game. And against St. Paul last week, they were 11-34 in the first half.
So the goal for Lenoxville, for Coach Cassavy, is really to try to pound it inside with Babin and Studhalter. They're their workhorse right now.
Well, they out-rebounded St. Paul 50-36, so that might be the passport to victory, is the rebounding. And that's a miscue by Lenoxville. They had about 24 turnovers a game. They had 42 in the loss to Dawson this season.
And that was the key. That was really smart foul here by Oliver here. They're calling it really tight. It's a lot of obstruction, but the key for... We know that Cassidy wants to bring the ball inside. Also, St. Foy knows that also. So they're, once that pass is there, they're double-teaming the big. And they usually like to double-team the big right away. Ooh.
And Garar is on the back, sliding through the blue paint. And there's a bit of a perplexing reaction from St. Foy. You see it from Kofi, who was surprised by that. And it appears it's going to go against Lenoxville.
Yeah, so they foul on 12 Kong there. Seems like she obstructed when the St. Foy player was going through this.
Giral. Facing up again is Trempe. Now going up against Babin. Denied by Studhalter. Recovered by St. Foy. And a whistle and a foul. And already the visitors from Lenoxville have 14 fouls running 4 minutes through.
But it's usually like that. Lenoxville is known as a scrappy team. Doesn't mean that they don't have skills. It's just that they're a scrappy team. They're handsy. And they're usually in foul trouble.
And for those who want to recall, they had to scrap their way into this playoff spot. They took out Vanier to get the last playoff spot. And here they are on this Friday afternoon.
Bergeron has the ball there. Very skillful player, Bergeron. Big pass here.
Gerard from the 45. Bullseye! Hitting from three-point range, 35%. And you talk about the fact she only had one rebound in the cameo against Lenoxville. They're off and running 7-4.
Great move by Sophie Bergeron, going baseline, and have a great shot for Daozi.
Tough shot, popped up in the air. Studhalter cannot finish that one. Rebounded by Kofi, and here comes Garar the other way on the afterburners. Garar against Ismar, into the paint, down low, and that pass sent back to Quebec City from Garar.
And Garar is one of those players where she's really right-handed, but she loves to go with her left and step. When she starts looking at you, you know she's going to penetrate. So that's her pet move.
So coming back in the game now is Paradis along with some reinforcements. And for Lenoxville, Ismar goes off, Oliver back in.
And there's Murphy right now for 22. Like, she's pretty. Murphy's has a good size on her, good point guard. Man. They're going to their bench now, though.
McBain went out with it. Studhalter in the post. This is her postal code and comes up with no mail, and back over comes the guard the other way. And now she looks like she's in fine form. Going from one end, draw pass into the paint, and the quick hands, courtesy of Langille, is the foul on her as Trempe tried to get around her.
Yeah, Langille is one of those quick hands. Usually she gets that steal, but this time the ref caught it. Now there are five team fouls with 5 minutes 22 left in the game in the first quarter. Could be a long quarter for Lenoxville here.
Alrighty, they're up by four, the biggest lead of the day, 5:22 left in this game. But you have to wonder for Lenoxville, can they play with dare in this game and really try and challenge a very good St. Foy team? They only give up 57 points during the regular season per game.
St. Foy is very sound. It's a sound team. It's going to be really hard to score. And if you start scoring too much, coach is going to put 1-3-1 press, 1-3-3 zone defense on you.
Oliver Studhalter from the free throw line, deflected up in the air. And back over it comes through a ping pong of legs. Garrard is knocked over. And already, we're not even halfway through the dynamique are in bonus for the rest of the quarter.
Yep, right now, you can see Lenoxville's having a hard time scoring. They're still at 4 points in the first 5 minutes, and they've been fouling. This could get out of hand really quickly here, Mo. if they keep on fouling them, and because they're not offensively, they're offensively challenged, Lenoxville. If Catherine Oliver's not scoring, it's hard. And what Lenoxville, what St. Flo is doing, they're making sure that they don't go to their pet play, meaning they don't go inside all the time. So right once the ball is passed to Lenoxville inside, they're double teamed right away.
Yeah, five times last eight games, Lenoxville has scored 60 points in a matchup. They won by 13 over Tony Villar, 8 by St. Foy, and here they are down by 5 with 4:56 left in this first quarter of action. Oliver, back out it comes, trying to get around Babang, and now we'll go back door towards Langille. On the byline, Garrard snatching that ball, jump ball, arrow. Well timed on the trap, and this will be Lenoxville possession.
And you see already, St. Foy's not, they're not joking around. Early in the game, he's already brought out the 1-3-1 zone. So not to allow them, not to have them get into any rhythms.
Quick hands and not looking at the ball was Fournier, and back with the, or the dynamic, and they punched him on that miscue.
Might be a timeout here, Mo, if they score St. Foy.
Garrard. Paradis open for the jumper. Too much depth on that shot. Popped in the air. Right to Catherine Oliver's hands. 4:25 left in this first quarter.
They need Oliver to do something to spark the offense here. They're still on four right now.
She's the cornerstone of this offense. Swung around for three. Back heel up in the air. Hits the stanchion. This goes back, and this is going to be a whistle, and this is going to be a foul on St. Foy. So now the law of averages plays into play with this whole foul game.
Usually that's what happens. The refs look at each other and say, okay, we've got to call some, maybe some calls on the other side just to even it out, not have the coaches start yelling at them.
I must say, right now for the Cougars, that's a tough shot coming from Babang. And this goes back over to Dynamic. I must say, Eric Segal, the coach of St. Foy, his Jordans are looking very crisp today on this Friday afternoon.
Very, very crisp. But not as crisp as my Jordans, but they're looking crisp. Segal is hell of a great coach. Like, I admire what he's done.
Yeah, absolutely.
They had a great start of the season, kind of floundered towards the end, but now it's playoff time. Win or go home.
Kofi, jumper from the line. Absolutely exquisite coming through.
11-4 Mo right now. It's danger zone. They're up 7 right now, St. Foy. St. Foy's like, oh, we don't got no jitters. We're ready to play. We're ready to win this game. And let's go play the St. Jean.
Last two games, they scored 55 points and 81 points. Here's a three. They need it. Splash going through. McBean, a 25% three-point shooter, did not play the win over St. Foy last week. And just like that, down by 4, Sean.
Oh, it's McBean. Sorry, McBean.
Long three. Bullseye. Alice Alonso, 38% from three, went 3 of 4 for 9 points and 3 rebounds in 24 minutes, and they're back up by a touchdown. Coming through from the flats, Langille. Stopping, popping, shooting, too strong, rebound right to St. Foy. And the rebounding numbers, St. Foy hits about 38 rebounds and almost identical with Lenoxville at 38 apiece. Into the paint, and this is going right down low to Paradis. Kick out, well defended by Lenoxville. And Segal not happy about that possession. Here's Oliver on the breakaway to make it 14-9.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
my God.
Heart and mouth moment for her, and her blushes will not be spread on that breakaway.
But that... The thing with Oliver, you know, that's not going to fluster her. She's going to come back and start scoring more points. So do.
And coming through the lane, and that is incomplete and recovered by Lenoxville with 2:25 left. So right now, St. Foy not putting this game further out. Segal wants a timeout, the next dead ball.
It makes sense to call a timeout. Like, it's been kind of disjointed right now. No timeout. He's going to got a sub in, right? He was able to sub in some players.
I thought he was going to give us a break over here, but I guess
He's not giving us a break. He's not giving Lenoxville a break either.
Nope, not at all. So Stutthalter back in the game. They bring in Canada Rock for the first time today, scoring about a point and a half for the Cougars. So some fresh legs for Coach Cassavy. And Stutthalter is impacted. You can see she's very ruthless inside the paint. She knows her way with the GPS. Her heat map is in that paint for the Lenoxville Cougars.
She's a seeking missile. She knows where her territory, where the perimeter is, where she needs to be is in the key. And Eric Segal knows that also. So he's pretty he's unhappy. Like an out-of-bound play, get an easy hoop like that, but they missed a free throw. So it's tough. It's tough for Coach Cassavy right now.
Yeah, for the year, they shoot 60% from the line as a team. They are 6th in the league. Made 41% against St. Foy, 81% against Momo. Last week, they were 3 of 9 from the first half against St. Foy.
That was tough. so hard for them to score. Now to miss both free throws.
And that's four lost points now. You think about the two missed free throws and the Oliver layup.
Yes. Could have been 14-11 right now. So big shot here.
Splash! It's now 17-7, courtesy of Trempe. 33% from three-point range. And already, she's off range. She shot 4 of 8 against Langsville last week. Cam Manny performs up by 10. And that is a foul, and that will be free throws for Sudhalter. And you can just see that the supply line for Lennoxville is going to go through the number 14 uniform of Sudhalter.
It has to go through there. Like, the perimeter shots are not hitting. Sudhalter's is their stud to go in there. So she's got to hit some free throws.
And she hits the first one. Sudhalter is a 51% free throw shooter, scoring about 8.5 points per game. And she went 7-11 last week in 30 minutes. She shot 47% from the field. 42 offensive rebounds.
Great from Sudhalter. Hit 2 points there. Kind of broke that trend now. It's 17-9. Hopefully they could build on this Lennoxville and get a good defensive presence. Well, Trompe is doing a nice move here.
Draw pass, trail move. Absolutely A-plus in that play. I log in on the cleanup.
Oh, great. Great tic-tac-toe. The hockey pass from Trompe. Got a great assist. Coach Segal's really animated right now, but on a good way. Like, he knows his team has come out to play hard. Double team.
From the right corner. Extra pass, Langeau, head fake, stopping from 17. Front iron, rebounded by the Dynamics' own Trempe.
That's a great defensive side right there. Well,
and a whistle, Ismar called for the foul. They almost went almost 5 minutes without a foul. And now it will be free throws coming up here for Kim Delaney, who is a 77% free throw shooter.
Yep. That was a tough one there. Like, defensive, you know that you can't, as a player, you have to know that Your team has five team fouls. You can't defend as tight as you want. You got to let the player go. And you don't want to start fouling players at half court.
And what makes it tough for the Lennoxville is that St. Paul's number one in the league at 70% per game, made 95% of the free throws against Tony Vieira. 54% against Momo is their worst effort this past season. And they hit the second one. And now an 11-point lead, the biggest lead for either side in this matchup. So homework to do now for Lennoxville. Could they chip away at the single digits?
They need Oliver to start scoring.
And here she is, Oliver. Langeau stopping. Back out it comes. Sudhalter with the left, fouled. And you can just see how silky smooth she is when it comes to her ability of her presence in the paint.
Yeah, if I'm Coach Cassidy, I'm not happy about that one. Even though you got the foul, Sudhalter should have been a little bit stronger to score that. So now you got to go to a free throw and hit both of them. She hits the first one. Got some subs coming in, Mo.
I think the best cure to any remedy when you're down by so many points is stopping clocking free throws made.
Definitely, Mo. Great insight there. That for sure. You want to stop.
That's the only insight I can provide for a basketball tournament.
Oh.
And that's a miss by Sudhalter. It remains 10-point lead. 43 ticks left in this first quarter of play. And here is Kim Delaney with it. Delaney on the byline. Switch of play. Open three. Splash! Trempe, second three of the day. They're up by 13.
Big shot by St. Foy.
McBain. Denied by Kofi. McBain stumbling. Oliver at the tippy toe, and she's knocked by Delaney. And that will be bonus time here for the Cougars, which in the nick of time, they were in a cul-de-sac and got out of it for free throws.
They really got out of that dead end there, Mo. Unfortunately, the lady had to foul there. Didn't need to. They were up against the shot clock. She knows better, but Coach Segal is really happy with the defensive presence that they're doing right now. That defensive intensity is pretty amazing. And as a coach, to come out of this game playing really well in the first quarter, they're not in jitters. They're really playing well. They're playing like how they played early on in the season.
Oh, absolutely. And the first free throw going in for Catherine Oliver. Scored 13 points, 5 rebounds, 5 of 20 shooting against St. Foy. They're down by 9. You talk about the psychological effort. If they keep this to 9 as opposed to putting this double digits, it's a massive mental win for them over the Dynamic. 6 left on the game clock. Garrard from the center arc. Front iron. Rebounded by Oliver. Through the legs of Kofi, and at the end of one, it is St. Foy 23, Lennoxville 12. We're through one with 3 to go. Stay tuned here from Champlain-St. Lambert.
vision. That's a no, sir. Hardest on earth. I'm not really from earth. We go down 911. I let off that clone first. I put in my own work. Better do your homework. I can hear that money calling. I pick up the first ring. What you gonna charge an old man for that? Girl, don't hurt me.
Ice out on my scammer. Boost all the insurance up. Ice out on my ghetto. Who turned into influencers. Smirky up. That they leave, I don't care who she back out her closet, hot as hell, she got on easy up. I got moves with me, bump out the feds, man, I got foes with me. You got goofies with you, before I do that, I keep some with me. Asking for my girl when I'm in Cali, this your city. Why you DM my box, I got like these hoes below silly. Street feet on Raymond, on like calamari. Took her at that chief, took her to Bulgari. Never tell her sorry, this car a Ferrari. Offset with this Cuban link, you think she was Cardi.
Three gang leaders with me all times. I don't know who I fucked last night. I got Alzheimer's, I don't know who them is, man, they all lying. Brody, tell me who them is, man, they all fine. 100 hooligans, and we with the foolishness. I'm anti-Semitic, I just school this booty, can we ran her like a lip? This got pregnant in the threesome, so whose baby is it? Whose baby is it? My putting Delta, pull up with the switches. This ain't Jimmy Butler, but the heat got extensions. This ain't Columbine, but we came in with the trenches.
Welcome back. Here's Sean Oliver, and it is Mo Khan on this Friday afternoon. Look at these first quarter stats. Beautiful shooting by St. Foy. 8 of 14, 4 of 7 from three-point range. Champlain-Lennoxville, not so great. 3 of 15 from the field.
Yep. We know that sometimes Lennoxville could be offensively challenged, and it's going to be tough. If St. Foy is going to shoot threes like this, it's going to be really hard for them to catch up because they're going to go, they try to go inside. Those are two-point plays where they're going against three-point shots, so it's a map problem.
And Kofi providing a mathematical equation of success, and they're up by a score of 25-12. And you see that flair merchant of her ability to bring that up to 13. Studhalter, too strong. Rebound, Babe. And in for two, and that is where they might have to get this going in favor of the rebounding numbers.
Well, it's the only way for them to come back in this game, but I think it's a map problem now. They're going to be scoring twos while what's his name, St. Foy, is going to be scoring threes.
Right now, St. Foy in form. Lennoxville slightly out of form in this first half. Kofi, Gerard, quiet first half from St. Foy. Splash! And they're up 14.
MVP, like I told you, it's a map problem. You're scoring two, they're scoring three each time. Each possession, that's plus one. So Lennoxville has to shore up their defense, get out on the three-point line, and have what's his name, St. Foy, penetrate.
And now the pressure picking up on the Cougars. Studhalter, and you can see now the exit options becoming very limited for the Cougars trying to get this ball to Studhalter in the paint.
Oh, no, definitely. Like, Coach Segal knows where they want to go. Oh, here comes Bergeron. Nice move, foul.
And Bergeron looking sumptuous in that play. And with her on four, timeout call. Wobbly legs for the Cougars. And right now, St. Foy is flying high. Welcome back here to St. Lambert's. It is Sean Oliver, it is Mo Khan. So plan A out the window for Lennoxville. They're on to plan B and they're down by 16.
They're in danger zone right now. If this gets up to 20, you can almost say that it's gonna be really difficult for them to come back. So they really need to lean on Oliver right now.
Well, if this scoreline were to hold up, we have a Dawson-St. Lambert game, and then it would be St. Foy against St. Jean. All eyes being watched by the Blues, Giants, and Cavaliers in this game. Oliver has to find her form. Does she have the guile to browse through? Not that time, and not that shot from Studhalter. And it's fire playing with fire, and Lennoxville's getting burnt right now by the fire of St. Foy.
Oh, no doubt. They knew. Coach Segal was like, cover Oliver. We know she can shoot that shot, so cover her. Don't make her get that easy shot. So they're well coached. They've scouted the hell out of Lennoxville right now.
Right now, Lennoxville trying to stabilize a struggling ship against St. Foy. Bergeron, Guerrault, high low with Kofi in the byline. And that is no good. That is a rebound. And here come Lennoxville the other way.
If I'm Lennoxville, I think it's time to play a zone. You're not able to move as fast as the player with the ball moves. So I would have to change up the rhythm if I'm Lennoxville.
Studhalter. And again, the presence of her has been defining, but she's not come up with the refined points. Yeah,
They need her to score there.
Teardrop is short, missed by Trampé and recovered by the Cougars. And here come the visitors from the Eastern Townships back forward.
I don't think there have been any scores right now in this quarter right now. 2 minutes, 3 minutes in. Oh, this looks like a backcourt.
And that will be a turnover by the Cougars. And for Lennoxville, that is turnover number 4. And it has been lacking the ecstasy for the Lennoxville Cougars in this game. Champlain Lennoxville trying to get themselves win number 1 on this playoff adventure. They lost to Dawson last year in the quarterfinals, who end up beating Champlain
yes.
in the semifinals. And today, it could very well be a Champlain-Dawson game tomorrow if Lennoxville does not win today.
Yeah, that's a foul right there on Bambe. She fell down. She caused her player to cause the player on St. Foy to fall down. They're just crisp now. You can see St. Foy well scouted Lennoxville, and their offense is running so crisp like it did earlier in the season when they were like one of the top three teams in the country. So they're, even though they didn't play that well the second half of the season, they're playing well. They're coming out like Mike Tyson here in the first round.
Alors, back out it comes. First touch for Sarah Maud Jacob in the game for the first time today. Back out to Guerrault. No good. Rebound off the ankle of Daradi. This goes back over to the Cougars. But they got to change this script now because they're down by 16 with 6:47 left before half.
And you see Segal. Coach Segal's not. He's still hungry. Look, he's changing up his defense. He has a 2-2-1 press right here. Just giving Lennoxville different looks.
Esmar trying to break this look down. Babang trying to find an outlet. Here is Langille going against Alar and the finger roll for Langille. She went 3 of 13 from the field, had 8 points, 4 rebounds in the win last Friday.
I've seen her a lot. Like, Langille is not bad. She's sneaky good. She has a lot of different plays. And her hands, good defensive player. Oh, moving screen, maybe. We got a moving screen.
And talk about the difference maker for St. Foy and Lennoxville last week. The Cougars had 14 assists from Babin and Kung. So they had 14 assists in total, but they had 7 from Kung and Babin, beg your pardon. So if they're going to win this game, that extra quality pass might be their passport to getting this game back in play.
Great insight there, Mo. They definitely need that. They need something more than just Oliver scoring. They need that balanced score here. Nice pass.
Langille eyes off the ball momentarily. And back out to Studhalter. And you can just see it's this robust number of gray uniforms crashing on Studhalter. And this remains Champlain ball with six to go in this first half.
You see the defensive principle from Segal is basically the ball goes inside, we're going to swarm. We're not allowed to play to your strengths. You're going to have to play left-handed here and find other ways to score. Oh,
Ismar finds a way to score. A rare set of points for her at 30-18 lead for the Dynamic.
So Lennox was kind of off the mat right now. They're playing well. Nice move, nice pass.
From the flats, splash. A big three coming through for Bergeron, who's coming to the game, shot 13% from three-point range, up by 15.
That's the offense. You can't get tricked by St. Foy. St. Foy, what's the nice move?
And one. Stellhalter going to the line.
great play. Great play finding Studhalter down low. But what I was saying before is, like, defensively, Lenoxville, you can't get sucked in when Niyazi's penetrated. She's looking to pass the ball on the wing for the three-point shot. They're not a team that's down low. They want to shoot at the threes. It's been like that forever at St. Foy.
And a missed free throw right there by Lenoxville. They are now, are you ready for this? 5-9 from the free throw line.
Wow.
Every point, the currency is viable, and they're down by 13.
Kofi's in her bag here. She's going to take her. That's
and
Kofi.
And Kofi does not get that to go in. It remains St. Foy ball. It's been one-way traffic. It's been bright and beautiful for St. Foy against the Cougars. And now, could the Cougars find out a key to unlock this door? Timeout call by St. Foy. 5:15 left here in this first half. Stay tuned from St. Lambert, Quebec.
Every time you come around, yeah, you ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those calls, I'm way too numb, yeah, it's way too dumb, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, I need the Heimlich, throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah, when you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yeah.
Welcome back here. It is Sean Oliver. It is Mo Khan on this Friday afternoon. And right now it's been delicious control for the St. Foy Dynamics. Been fruity and juicy. And right for the Lenoxville Cougars to get themselves back in this game. They're down by 13. Still manageable, but they cannot allow St. Foy any more easy baskets.
Easy baskets and three-point shots. They got to guard the three. And now you're in another one.
And that's a miss. They are now 6 of 11 from three-point range.
Yeah, like I said, the map problem there. They got so many threes. Nice take by Ishmar. Oh, no foul. Oh,
no foul in that play. Garrard back with it. South of 5, 13-point lead. And back over comes to Trampé. Head fake, Bergeron. And she's fouled by Kung. And you can see Sophie Bergeron is an absolute magician with her St. Foy trickery and magic on display today.
Saw that play. They're trying to saw that play by Sophie Bergeron. At the three-point line, fake, drove, nice take by her, third-year player, defensive player of the year in the Q. Sophie's a hell of a player.
Yeah, they went 10-15 in the first half from the free throw line. So far today, they are now 4 of 7 from the line. And you talk about the balanced scoring for St. Foy. Last week, they had three players at 10-plus points. Bergeron, Kofi, Trampé scored a total of 39 points of what they had against Langsville last week.
I love Eric Segal's demeanor. Last week, he didn't have Niyazi, but he wasn't harping on his players. This game, he's like so much encouragement, having them play hard. Oh, nice play by Studhalter again.
Studhalter will go to line for two. 4:36 left here for Coach Cassidy. In this game of chess right now, he's got to figure out how to unlock this St. Foy door, which has not been as easy as he thought it could have been. But he said before tip-off, this is going to be a tough game. We have to be near perfect to win a game like this against the Queens of the Manor in St. Foy.
Definitely, St. Foy. Key is to cover the three-point shot, and they got to get better offensively. It's going to be a struggle for them. They want to get this game down into the 60s. St. Foy's trying to bring this up to, like, they might get up to 80 to 90 points this game, St. Foy, with how they're hitting the threes.
St. Foy, or Champlain Lanceville, gives up about 65 a game, gave up 74 to St. Jean, which is the most they've given up all season long, and that ball is sent back towards the St. Lawrence up in the St. Foy area.
Segal's okay. Segal has given Kofi that freedom, but that one, he wasn't happy about that. Like, that was really out of structure. It was early in the shot clock. Late in the shot clock, down. The last third of the shot clock, give her. You can do whatever you want. Not early in the offense. Not like that.
One dribble, two dribbles, short rebound right to St. Foy. Whistle, other way we go. Foul on Champlain Lenoxville. 4:07 left into this first half. I'm not saying the margins are starting to tighten here for Lenoxville, but right now the options are not as plentiful as they want in terms of the offensive attack.
No, definitely. And it's tough for Lenoxville because Babe had a great move there, just missed it, and then she foul the player now. So three team fouls on both sides right now, Mokan.
Gehal back out over, and here is Kofi. And Kofi, the soft touch around, and it's a 37-22 lead. And you can see the class that she has at her fingertips.
And I told you, like, that's what Coach Sagal wants. Go down low, give us some offensive diversity. We're not only here three hell, but here comes a layup for her.
Kofi, point number four on the second trip in a row. And you see how difficult it is to break through. Timeout call by Cassidy. They're down by 17. 3:34 left in this first half. Stay tuned.
Big game here.
Welcome back here to St. Lambert, Quebec. 3:34 left in this first half. Sean Oliver, Mo Khan. And this is now becoming almost a big gulf of distance with the scoreline being up 17 for St. Foy.
When you're the favorite, you love this. You're up 17. You can play freely. The underdog is like, ah. Oh. Now it's trying to set in. Oh, yeah, they are really better than us. So it's really tough. Like, the goal for Lenoxville is trying to get this down to 10. I know that's aggressive, but they try to get down, try to get some positive play. Not another steal here.
Here's Bergeron, 201. Kofi to her right. Bergeron. Excellent pass denied by Babang, and they had about 3.5 blocks per game. They had 7 against St. Paul last week, and that was a big one of intervention by her.
That's great steal by Bergeron, don't get me wrong, but she took too long with the ball. Fake pass, and then passed it. Had she just passed it, a traditional 2-on-1, Kofi would have had an easy layup. Instead, it was a block.
Ismar from the 45. Back out to Babang, facing up now against Trempe. Oliver has been quiet so far. Trying to negotiate, and that is taken away. And that's taken away back right by St. Foy. Go from one way to the other way. And a foul will be called on Babang. And you can just see the frustration on the physical expression of Champlain-Lenoxville in this first half.
Coach Cassidy is telling Catherine, just move the ball, you'll get it back. Don't try to go into lanes where there's no gaps. There wasn't any gap right there. Sorry, move the ball, get it back, and get an open shot.
Gigal. Here she is again from the center arc against Oliver. Around one, kick out from the corner pocket. Rims out, rebound, St. Foy, and a foul. And going to the line will be Alice Allah, who is, I don't want to jinx her, 100% from the free throw line.
Wow, that's amazing. 100% for the season, That's really good. It's born really good. That's outstanding. But
17-17 this year, and she had 29 offensive rebounds, so she has a magnet for rebounds.
Shooter jinx. I told you, jinx. You jinxed her. You jinxed her, Mo. 17 for 18, you jinxed her, Mo.
She's out of form on that free throw. And now looking to get back in form on this free throw attempt. And she does. 40-22 lead, and they're up by 18. And back in the game now will be Kim Delaney. No subs for Cassidy, and he can't wait for the team top to come. They're 2:28 away from that, and he needs to get things recalibrated and reconfigured.
No, they have to recalibrate, but also got to shore up. You can't always sink in. Let Niozzi try to go for that layup. Don't always come and sink in on the, especially on the strong side there. That's a no-no.
Oh, the push-off, and that is going to be a whistle. In the game is Claire Fournier in for the first time, scoring about 2.5 points a game. Has shot 60% from the field, had 6 points, 4 rebounds in the victory, and 26 defensive rebounds.
So one way for Lenoxville to get back into this game is try to go back inside, But they're always going inside, but try to get some fouls here. Stop the clock. Hit your free throws.
So Trempe in, and out is Paradis. No subs again for Caspi. Ismar on the end line. A cue of about 9 inside the blue paint. And Ismar has to get this over, and that is 5-second violation. She went 6 seconds. And you can just see right now that the style points has been lacking for Champlain-Lenoxville in this first half.
Yeah, it's tough there. Like, Lenoxville needs every possession. They need to be very efficient when they're on offense, so you can't just give up a 5-second count like that.
You know Dawson and St. Jean are watching with great intent, anxious to get themselves underway, which they will tomorrow. Kofi.
In their bag.
Kofi with the teardrop. Short, rebounded by Oliver.
155 steal,
left.
Steal!
Kofi makes out for the miscue. Oliver's blushes will not be spared on that play.
I tell you, Kofi brings them a different dynamic. Not your traditional safe four player. Not to say she's not skillful, it's just that she just gives that one-on-one presence that they've been lacking.
They're coming in robust numbers, denied by Alon, and here comes the dynamic the other way. Long ball, well deflected away by Ismar, looking like a DB out there, and about to come in the game for the Cougars. Obi Bett in for the first time today.
Seems like Coach Cog's going to call a timeout there.
1:26 left, 20-point lead, St. Paul up. Stay tuned for the final 86 seconds of this first half.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, I remember syrup sandwiches and crumb allowances, finessing on them with some counterfeits, but now I'm counting this. Parmesan with my accountant lives, in fact, I'm down in this. You say with my boo babe tastes like Kool-Aid for the analyst. Girl, I can buy your Westie world with my base stuff. I know that it's good, won't you sit it on my taste buds? I get way too ready, won't you let me do the extras? Pull up on your block and break it down, we playing Tetris. AM to the PM. My left stroke just went viral. Right stroke put a baby in a spiral. Soprano C, we like to keep it on the high note. It's levels to it, you and I know. Tell them be humble. Hold up. Sit down. Sit down. Be humble. Sit down.
Be humble. Welcome back here. Sean Oliver, MoCon. Key stat to look at here. Sean is the starting fives for both teams. Lenoxville's starting five has produced 17 points, which isn't bad normally. However, for St. Foy, they've had 34 from their starting five.
Yep. There's a lot of stats. Nazi MVP
and showing. Make it 37. Garand showing her MVP class. Two-pointer. They're up by 22.
Yeah, Nazi's come out to play. That week off was really helpful.
And right now, it's no longer a hill, but a mountain to climb for the Cougars. Obi Bett for three. Side rim, rebound Garal. 1 minute left in this first half. And it cannot come any sooner for the Cougars.
Lay up.
And that was one pass too many. Fournier on the interception. And here come the Cougars the other way. And they are fizzy skinny right now, trying to get their bearings back straight. Whistle and a foul. And Fournier will go to the line. A 53% free throw shooter of the season. And if you think about quarters, in the last game, St. Foy outscored Lenoxville 21-9. And right now, St. Foy has outscored Lenoxville 21-10 in this second quarter.
Coach is saying that the foul should be on 7, not 1, or 1 or not 7.
It's all about the allocation of fouls.
Oh, no, definitely, but... Definitely doesn't want Sophie Bergeron to have another foul on her. Like, that's the defensive player of the... Oh, no, that's at least Alar, maybe.
And now back over. New 14 for the Cougars. Champlain trying to get a few more points with 38 seconds left. Through the arms and a violent ending right there for Kiana LaRocque. And that will be free throws here again for the Cougars at the line once more.
Yep. Posted up. Seems like she got shoved. So two free throws. They got to capitalize on these free throws right here. It's down 20.
Delaney and Paradis back in the game. 36 seconds left as Garrard will get a respite for the remainder of this first half. I think she's earned that up by 22.
Definitely, definitely she's earned that. Get a little rest. We charge the batteries for the second half there. If I'm Coach Seguel, I'm like ecstatic, but I'm not there yet. Like I'm up 20. You know, the night before you don't sleep well when you're the coach. You're like, oh, I'm the favorite. And how could I win? You try to devise ways like how to make sure that we don't lose this game. You're the favorite. And he's happy right now.
Fempe. Delaney. He'll be happy
shot.
For three. That's off the range, and that is out of play. He won't be happy about that.
Well, they're up 20, 19, 21 points right now. Yes, he's not happy with a missed shot, but it was an open shot. Kofi could definitely hit it, but he preferred that it should be in the paint.
18 seconds left. Last roll of dice for the Cougars. This could help their confidence if they get this shot late. Are we bet now with it? Going towards the right, help along the way. Back up to Ismar. Too much depth. Cleanup is better. And at the end of the first half, it is St. Foy 44, Champlain Lennoxville 25. We're through 20 with 20 to go. Could the Cougars pull off the smash or grab? We'll find out here in the second half. Stay tuned.
Baby, let's ride on with my dogs. I pick the side. She want the boss, the one on the track. I'm at the one that just throw it when we ride. I did the corner straight, the wheel in the ties. Between them, on the boat till they tied. Everybody on. You know you need me, man. Just keep it real, don't you cry with your song. Who else? The city like us when it rains, it's a thunderstorm. I party at Shabba in New York and LA, where they keep on going to the dungeon. Shabba, 200K what I'm on. She leaking out down my chest. Yeah. I told her I ain't shine, but call me sex. It ain't no dough I put the racks in. Yeah. If you my call you sexy. So far in time, I've been whipped up in nine. I've been whipped up in whip my fists up in dry. I've been whipped up in time. I've been picked up in night. I've been working in time. I've been with my inside. I've been just like, it's just life. It's just life. It's just life.
Face down, we still talking codes. I think feds on every iPhone. No more polo t-shirts, put that shit on every day from now on. Switching on my image, no more picture with my styrofoam. Why the fuck I keep buying these houses if I'm never home? I'm with gang, ain't never wrong. Supermodels, I'm stepping on. Search for my weapon on. 5, 3, 4 bags in one time. Treat the corner like a trap house. Other spot a baby compound. Bad getting run around. Bro, track star, you run shit down. I made this shit happen with one. I told bro to one band one time. She like, fuck, so that stay in. Now she gotta get new tape in. Pockets too big, they can never belittle me. Man, I'm a ain't with her arguing, what's your dilemma? How about Achilles, the real ones? How you the hero, but stay with some villains? I ain't gon' switch on my I run the game like I'm born with a ball. Yagging ain't corny at all. 5'9", but I ain't that small. Feel like I'm 7 feet tall. Bro ain't stopped, he just on pause. He coming true when I call him. FaceTime, we still talking codes. I think the feds on every iPhone. No more polo t-shirts, put that shit on every day from now on.
In millions of dollars, marketing product, drinking out styrofoam. Had a talking code when you on FaceTime like the feds on phone. Live a big in that lifestyle, but I still give to your dose. Little one got the stick, ready to go blitz. Little one stay on go. Flatline, the one car. Put a what's up in U-Haul. Dodging the lights, sitting this popping all this that I talk. I done piped up another. Something too rich, my fault. I just alley-ooped my dog, he just slammed up the ballin' like Brian, but now starting to feel like Messiah. So I ain't no drinking, but I swear the money get me higher. Heard a judge, I'm on my mansion, got marble. Charge an M for a show, still a sell a bill to you tomorrow.
FaceTime, we still talking codes. I think the feds on every iPhone. No more polo t-shirts, put that shit on every day from now on. Everybody can flow, but I won't. Everybody want it, but I don't. I mean, follow and I lead. I mean, come and I leave. Virgil made back, be so sweet. We just get them, ain't no beef. You can get her back, I can't keep her. We be getting shit, that's our secret. Rappers wanna kick it, can't reach. You ain't five of y'all, can't see me. Really sturdy water, can't beat me. Academic, no, he ain't bitching me. Brody ready, he for 20 feet. Ain't got nothing to say to you, minimies. Ready to buy a little contract. Yeah, yo, whatever, we on that. Disappeared on them, they got weird on me. On the fall back, king. Number one, shit, man, King Pluto. That's a smooth tag team. Gotta live with it, can't wake up from it. This is not a bad dream. Look how life changed. TV's in the shower, used to steal flash screen. Shh.
Shoot the cavalry up. Bullet sneezing, we got allergies. We got alibis. We got calibers. Categorized. FN capitalized. Better record.
I got sick and tired of letting slide. So I'm in the whip. I got the stick inside. If I sniff a scent, smell a lie. Smell a crack a smile. Let it rip. Let it ride. First time, second line. Second time, bloodline. Third time, even I die. Taking one of mine. I'm on Keller Road with a chopper from Columbine. Creeping on the cracker trying to colonize.
We've got out of this. this shit.
Forsaken me, in God I trust, so I get money faithfully, not just occasionally. Got to make cake every day like I work for a bakery. I know you push the secrets, not safe for me. You crazy, you think you gon' take from me. Not for extorting tree pilots like Ork, and I call us some callers. I know this gon' spray for me. Speaking in cocaine, they taping me. Let out the whole clip, leave a vacancy. I'm out that 2 with the 6 on, basically. Rapping more shooters than Rich Paul's agency. They get the clutching, you best get the ducking like 6'7". That's dunking for Oregon. Money so long, if I start in the south and then spread this shit out, it be touching like Portland. So it's no wonder I'm walking with caution. I know that God got his grace for me, but I still treat a ride through the hood like I hike through the woods. Got a stick that I take with me.
The spaceship, now I'm a space cadet. Big white mansion in my habitat. Aim a lot of stage like a laser tag. Fuck a rich, have a rich set. Smoke a lot of trees, need a weed plant. I did take all in where to lean at. Sleeping on these G's is a beanbag. Got red going jeans, cause a cool rap. Checking from my fan, life is fantastic. I was broke as hell, sleeping on the mattress. So I felt like a hell when nobody happened. Hot shells jumping out, they send me automatic. When it all about it, shoes overseas, they were pan level. Shop in Tokyo, Japan, they the best of them. Blue bear t-shirt, sleeve vanilla. Hard top, turn the vert, riding any weather. Ain't gotta bend down, this ain't a propeller. Man, we spend it dying, copping Gucci sweaters. Instead of dripping niggas, drowning, I cannot help them. It's booming out of guys, we are not the devil. Got Colombia ties out of Mexico. Spent the beds 100 times, still smell. Got some pimp, feel applying, feel like Velcro. I'm vanilla, shopping on Rodeo. I be if you don't want copy, visit Dayo. Bro, gonna get a payroll. I just want the pretty women in the pesos. I can only hit an engine in this Lambo. On a spaceship, now I'm a space cadet. Big white mansion in my habitat. Aim a lot of stitch like a laser tag. Fuck a rich, have a rich set.
Smoke a lot of trees, need a weed plant. Did tickle, ain't where to lean at. Sleeping on these G's, is a beanbag. Got me going jeans, cause I'm cool, right? Bought a spaceship, now I'm a space cadet. Big white mansion in my habitat.
Welcome back here to St. Lambert at halftime. St. Foy 44, Langsville 25. And the reason why the Cougars are down by 19, the three-point shooting of the Dynamic, 6 of 13.
6 for 13. Also, they're 16 for 31. They're almost shooting 50, shooting a little bit more than 50%. And unfortunately for Langsville, they're 8 for 25. Let's see how they start off this quarter here.
And they're short. Studhalter is fouled, and that's a better start than before. And for young Studhalter, so far today, 9 points, 2 of 5 shooting, but she's taking a meat grinder of physicality from the St. Foy Dynamic.
Well, she can handle it. Like, that's her. She's been playing that position the whole season in the last 18 games. So that's their offense. Give it to Studhalter and try to get to the free throw line.
And Studhalter missing the first free throw. And so far, the Cougars, unfortunately, 8 of 16.
If they're going to try to mount a comeback, like you said, Mo, they're going to have to hit their free throws. Let's see here. It just started right now.
So first point for the Cougars. Trying to get themselves back in this game, down by 18. And here is Naoti Giral, who is trying to add some more gloss in the lead. Backdoor, Kofi, kick out, and that goes out of bounds. Last touch by Trempe.
Great defensive presence by Lennoxville. They're still in the man-to-man. May Coach Cassidy just say, just shore up some stuff. Let's clean up those gaps and play better defense here. Oop.
Quick hands coming through the lane. Jump ball, elbowing, back out, extra pass. Ismar, teardrop, too strong, rebound. And this remains Lennoxville ball with 9:10 left, 5 left in the shot clock. So no new 14.
So they need really Catherine Oliver to come out now and show what she is, what she could do. Like, first team all-star, got to start scoring now. It's your last game of the season if you don't come out. 5 second count here, Mo.
Ooh. And they get off quickly and back out. 3 left on the shot clock. Well read by Garrard. 2-on-1. Naoti Garrard, the Rolls Royce. Looking like a Toyota on that ending. And they can still get the ball with new 14 left.
But Toyota's reliable, Mo. Come on now. Wasn't a Rosewood, but Toyo's reliable. Most sold car in North America.
And that time, the reliability was not there for the Dynamic. Ismar looking very reliable in that play. 44-28 lead.
Great score by Ismar. It's a good start. It's a good start. They're down by 16 now. The start that Coach Cassidy wanted. The team is playing well. Seems they got off the canvas a bit. They're playing much better defensively right now. Well, nice shot.
With the pirouette, splash. Naoti Giral. One of the big hitters showing the dark arts of basketball to her finest, 46-28 lead.
Definitely, she's playing like an MVP. She is the MVP of the Q right now.
High-low, Studhalter, Garrard looking like a DB. She's everywhere. Kofi on the run. They're on the front foot. They're smelling blood in the water. Kofi, pirouette, and in for the style points. Crafted and created the arts and crafts on display.
She put Murphy in the spin cycle. Great shot by Kofi right there. Back up to 20.
Kick out, right corner pocket. Bullseye going through for McBain. 25% three-point shooter. They were 0 of 5 in the second half against St. Foy last week from three-point range.
McBain is a scorer. Like, she's good. Coming back from an injury, she's really good. A couple threes for her, I think, this game though.
Second three of the day for the year. They shoot 21%, Lennoxville. They shot 10% in the loss to St. Jean, 36% in the loss to Champlain. They make about 3.5 threes per game. They went 0-15 in the win over Vanier, and they won by a single point. So they have these high risk, high rewards, and sometimes when they don't score, they still win.
Nope, definitely there. But McBain is a scorer. Even though don't let that knee brace deceive her. She's a scorer. She could play.
She's a fabulous player for Lennoxville. Again, high-low, Kofi. That's her address.
Kofi's looking to get a technical foul there. Like, she's looking at the players, giving maybe a small sign. She's borderline going to get a technical foul. The way she's staring at the players after she goes down there, it's getting a little disrespectful.
Well, we're on a collision course now, Sean, of some history with some of these teams. If St. Paul were to hold on, we would have for the third consecutive year a Dawson-Champlain playoff battle. and someone would end their season for the third consecutive season, whether it's Doss or Champlain. And Saint-Foy and Saint-Jean, a rematch of last year, or a big part of a rematch, and won.
Patrick Oliver.
And a big shot coming through for Bazin. And I was saying before, it would be a rematch of last year's semifinal between Saint-Foy against Saint-Jean.
They've been the top four teams for the last couple of years now in the queue. So let's see. If it holds form, round three, Champlain-Dawson.
I think Momo would like to have a word with that next year.
Definitely. With the way Laurent's played, they have a bright future.
And right now, the future is they're up by 16. Saint-Foy looking very bright for a rematch with Saint-Jean. Kofi with it. Kofi trying to find an outlet. Kofi will go by herself. Kick out open. Garrard, extra pass for three from the 45. Splash! Trempe with the three. Breathtaking basketball by the Dynamic.
You can't let... That was a great off. Kofi held the ball a little bit too long, but now as he found Trempe, Trempe is just like... It's not a... It's a traditional set shot. Nice move by her. Nice score. Whoa.
Ismar for three. Bullseye! And a big response of an ace. Down by 16. But still work to be done by the Cougars.
There's still work to be done, but you can see offensively they're scoring now, which could give them more energy on the defensive side. So if you're Coach Cassidy, you're happy how your team started out. Here, a big shot by Trempe.
Trempe in the lane, to the left, to the right, and in off the clank. And they're back up, 55-37.
Big shot there.
So right now it's been a dreamy third for Saint-Foy, and a whistle and a foul as McBean got impacted by one of the Dynamic players out there. 6-11 left in this third quarter.
McBain is really good for them. Like, she's a good player. You saw that. It's not a lot of people do that fake dribble handoff. She was able to do a fake dribble handoff and get to the rim and get a foul there. So you're seeing that Lenox Hill's finding ways to score easier than they were doing in the past.
You talk about this Saint-Foy team. They won two of the last three coming into this tournament. They went winless in the month of January, 0-4. In fact, that was their architect of downfall because they were controlling their division side against Saint-Jean, and that enabled Saint-Jean to get back in and catch him and surpass him for the first spot.
Definitely. Like we said earlier on today, like Saint-Foy was like a top three team in the league. They were on fire. They beat Champlain in overtime. They had beat Dawson. They were undefeated at a certain point in the season. And afterwards, like you said, there was a lull in the season, but now they're here and they're firing all cylinders.
Here's Kofi. She has been in fuego. And that ball almost got in the hands from Bergeron. Open three. And that's a miss from Alar. And that is a whistle. That is going to go against the Dynamic Cougars ball. 5:51 left here. They're down by 16. And this is the key now for Lanceville. They have to stay composed and now convert these stops for points.
Oh, definitely there. Definitely, like Lenoxville's taking a look at, okay, we got a defensive stop. Now it's time to try to score some points. Let's see what McBain can do, and let's see what Oliver can do right here. Ishmar has been scoring for them, so let's not forget Studhalter. Whoop.
And here is a chance for Fournier. Open three, Ishmar. Missing that one. Rebound, Kofi. And her foot is on the line, and... I thought it was out of bounds, her foot, but yeah,
You got better eyes than me. I'm not sure. Ref was closer than we are, so let's go with the ref's call right now.
Never go against me when it comes to the 50-50 situations there.
I definitely won't go against you.
So the supply route now for Lenoxville has to be Ismar, who's been probably the best player in the second half for the team in blue and white. And here she is. Sidecar pass, Oliver. And it has not been her day. It's been a migraine of effort for her in this game against Saint-Foy today.
But you know, what do you know about Oliver? She's going to keep on scoring. Keep on
and
shooting.
That's a score bucket right there for the Dynamic. And they extend their lead up to 18.
I mean, you're gonna see Oliver. She's going to keep on shooting. She's going to find her rhythm. But Bergeron's on her. Like you got an all-star first team, and you got the defensive player of the year, Bergeron. So
Studhalter. Stopping, popping, loose ball. It remains. Lenoxville ball, 8 left in the shot clock. And now coming to the game for Lenoxville will be Larocque along with
Babain.
Timeout called by Cassidy, 4:52 left, 57-39 lead. And we now have the timeout call. Cassidy called for the timeout. He's looking. And he called timeout. So after the delay of 4 seconds, timeout called by the Cougars. Stay tuned late in this third quarter.
Like a sprained ankle, boy, ain't nothing to play with. Started off local, but thanks to all the haters, I know G4 pilots on a first name basis. In your city, faded off the brown. Nino, she insists she got more class. We know, swimming in the money, come and find me. Nemo, if I was at the club, you know I balled. Chemo, dropped a mixtape that sounded like an album. Who'd have thought a countrywide tour be the outcome? Labels want my name beside an X like an album. Everybody got a deal, I did it without one. Yeah, I'm about my business.
Welcome back here from St. Lambert, Quebec, and the shooting display has been a dreamy effort for St. Foy at 53%, and right now it's been a bit muddled for the Cougars at 37%, but they're 57% in this quarter alone, which is a better marked improvement for them.
Oh, no, definitely there. It's kind of discouraging for Lenoxville right now. The score right now is 14-13 for them, so they just shaved off 1 point off of St. Foy, a big shot by number six there, Mo.
By Paradis, and she will add more gloss to the lead. They're up by 20. And the finger roll is in this time for Lily Langille, scoring about 5.5 a game. And if there is one effort that has not gone the way of Lenoxville today, has been the rebounding. They had only 14 compared to the 20 for the dynamic so far in this ballgame. That's picked, and here come the Cougars the other way. A 3-on-2. Oliver down the left wing. Oliver, and that is a moment of despair for her because it has not been her day, and you have to figure that is becoming quite the dead end for her. It's been a big flat for her, essentially.
Yeah, that one could have been a better decision there. She had a player ahead of her. She could have passed it. They made an easier play, but she's a scorer. She thought she's been scoring like that throughout the season, so it's a little bit tough for her.
Yeah, the science was not perfect on that shot, but now it appears Lenoxville going to a 2-3 zone.
Yeah, they're going to try something. Like you said, plan 8 is up, big shot.
And that's off the side backboard, and that worked that time for Tampe as she has a smile with that. They're down by 18 with 3:51 left. Obviously, the ideal deficit would be inside 10 with 3:51 left, but this needs a few more points and a plethora of stops from the Cougars.
So now they're in their 1-3-1. 1-3-1 defense here. This is their bread and butter zone here. It's really hard to solve.
Back out to Langille. Too spicy of a pass coming from the rock. Swung around the protractor. 6 left in the shot clock. Kung. And that was an erratic shot. And this will be a turnover. And this will be a foul.
Charge.
And now the bigger inquest for Lenoxville is how do they get points, and they cannot find it at all right now in this matchup.
Yeah, it's going to be really tough for them right now, especially now that it seems like Eric Sakal is going to the 1-3-1 press, 1-3-1 zone, which is really hard to solve, right? Traditionally, teams like to play the 2-3, the 1-3-1. There are some shots in the corner. That's one of my preferred zones if I was still coaching. Oh.
Open space, Gerard. Bergeron, and that ball is sent towards the nation's capital in Quebec.
Definitely, Bergeron knows that she made a mistake there. Traditionally, St. Foy's always going to have a player on the opposite side corner, but that there was nobody there, so she acknowledged, well, good defense by Bergeron.
Trying to twist and turn is McBain. Back door, and again, it is a robust length of arms, and that ball is sent back towards Sherbrooke by Lenoxville. And they're onto plan D. Yeah. And they skip over plan C.
Because, you know, when you play Lennox, when you play St. Foy, you know you're going to get that 1-3-1. You just don't know when, but you know you're going to bring it out just to break the rhythm offensively of the other team. And right now they've got two possessions. They're trying to go to third. Big shot by Bergeron. Big
Bullseye!
Shot!
Bergeron getting that in. And you can see the confidence, the arrogance of Saint-Foy is brimming. They are sending a warning shot to Saint-Jean, to Dawson and Champlain, that they're here to play. Because a few weeks ago when they were on this court against Champlain, they were nowhere near of what they're doing today against Champlain-Lennoxville.
And I think the other teams are saying, hey, that's Lennoxville. When they play us, it's not going to be the same story. So I hear what you're saying, Mo. Yes, they're sending a strong message to the upcoming opponents. But the other upcoming opponents are saying, we're ready. We're ready for you also.
And for the upcoming opponent, if this scoreline holds, we will have a Saint-Jean, Saint-Foy, tete-a-tete.
That's going to be interesting. That's going to be an interesting one, Doug.
That is going to be fascinating. But again, for Lennoxville, they're trying to make it a little bit of a glitchier opportunity here and try to get themselves back in this ball game. Because if Lennoxville were to come back to win, we would have Saint-Jean, Champlain, St. Lambert, and Lennoxville would play Dawson in the other semifinal.
Yep. So that's a big if right now. They're up 20. They haven't. Right now, St. Foy's up 20. They're playing really well. They're gelling offensively. Defensively, they're playing great. That 1-3-1 is going to be hard to solve. So if I'm Lennoxville, just grind away, play a different type of defense. The man-to-man wasn't working. Try zone. There's nothing to lose. Your season, you have 12 minutes left in your season right now.
And back in the game is Ismar. And unfortunately for some of the big hitters on this Lennoxville team, they have not had success that they've had throughout the regular season. They went 10-8 in a very tough division with Vanier, Champlain, and Dawson. From the corner pocket, that rims out from Bergeron. That is a rebound for Babin. And here is Langille the other way.
Langille has, she might take it, she might take it.
Langille will take it. Thought she was fouled, no call, recovered by Saint-Foy, and here is Girard the other way.
Yeah, I felt like she was fouled there, but Langille's going to go back. She's going to go back to the rim the next time also.
From the center arc, coming through is Trempe, back out. Kofi spinning, kick out, and again, the telepathy of passing has been having a couple of potholes.
Yeah, right now a little sloppy right now. When you're up, you know, you're a little bit overconfident. You're up 18 points, so you're not as sharp as you should be, you know. It's just human nature to get a little sloppy when you're up that many points.
140 left in this third quarter play. Babang, double team, cannot get through the telescopic arms of Garang and Alal.
It's tough there. Like, I think Babang has to kick it out and then repost right there because they're double teaming when she puts the ball on the ground when she's in the post.
Back door, well read by Sarazin, and here come the Cougars, 2-on-1. And that is a kickball by Garang, who was dead to rights and had to use the jaws of her feet.
That was a messy play right there. Nice kickball. Saved their team 2 points right there because that was a nice traditional two-on-one play. Nobody fading out to the three. Could have been an easy two hoops there. So this is a chance where Lennoxville could try to make some hay. Some of the top hitters are off right now. They have to try to score here. They need to get points.
Back to the old traditional three-day format. And that's a miss from Langille. We had the Tuesday,
yep,
then Saturday, Sunday, but now they've gone to the Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So whoever were to win on the Friday games will really have earned their chance to win gold at the Provincials.
And I think that's most of the other conferences is the same way. They start all on travel there.
Back out. Open space. Kofi. That was blocked by Larac, and this will go back over to the Cougars. With 43.4 left.
Marie's looking back at the ref saying, hey, I got fouled there, but she took too long to shoot that ball.
For three, missed by Sarazin, rebounded by Alal. Another one and done for the Cougars.
Yep. So right now, Coach Segal was able to steal some minutes, got his top players to sit down right now. Oh.
And the quick hands, and that is going to be team foul number three, first on Sarazin. And Eric Segal coaching like he's down 18.
He's been waiting all year for this game right now. So definitely, go ahead, Mo.
Coach Cassidy has a Yoda-like approach right now.
Big shot here.
For three. That is off the window. Using the geometry is Delaney. A 35% three-point shooter. Sarazin is short. And this goes out of bounds. 7.6 left. Same foul ball. And you get to see that there is a that exuding a confidence from the team in gray and blue. Or wolf gray, that's what
no,
it is.
Definitely, like right now, they're exuding confidence. Right now, it's kind of deflating. So hard to come back in the game, and then somebody hits a internet banking shot. It's tough. It's really tough.
It comes to jeopardy for St. Foix. Here is Gahal, the ringleader of this process. Alal from center arc, and that did not have what they want. So at the end of three, St. Foix up 65-44 over Lennoxville. Stay tuned here from Champlain St. Lambert.
Tea time like I got a cup of this. Tea time like golf at a quarter to six. I love the on a regular. Famous blame, but they stay on my. Heard your new joint is embarrassing. You talk to the cops on some therapy. You act like you love this America. But really the truth is you're scared of the six. Yeah, you're scared of the six. Yeah, you're scared of the six. Your bodyguard put in some work on the flute. Now you wanna go and inherit it. Don't talk to the boy by comparison, or come to the boy on some arrogant. The weapons we got are some terrorists. Like TV producers, we airing it. She asking for bread for her parents. I told her I don't got no cash, and she said she could wait on a rack on some Arabic. I pull out a million to stare at it. My dick just got hard cause a wire just hit. My schedule's out, come spin us for real. Man, fuck all that spinning the narrative. I melt down the chains that I bought from your boss. Give a fuck about all of that heritage. Since V not around, the members done hung up the Louis. They not even wearing it. Don't come to the boy about repairing some. Don't come to the boy about sparing some. You lucky that Vogue was suing, cause I would have been with the Wassers in Paris. And they scared of the seven. After 1-3, then we turn up 11. Keep it open like 7-11. We at the house, I got 7 in heaven. They think I'm satanic, I keep me a rebel. Let's shorty a therapist.
Welcome back here. Fourth quarter action. Look at the stats here. The did not make 52% from three, 42% from the field, 40% from three. The Lennoxville Cougars, Champlain, that is, 32% from the field, 23% from three-point range. Not the most pristine effort for Champlain Lennoxville against the Dynamic de St. Foix.
And what's tough is for Lennoxville, you're 3 for 13 on threes, you're shooting 13 for 40 from the field. You're not getting enough offensive rebounds. Right now, you have 4 offensive rebounds. It's really hard to find ways to win the game when you're in a deficit in all those stats.
Gagal, here is Kofi. Splitting through two. Kofi rebounded by Larocq and a whistle far away from the net. And this will be the first team foul on the Dynamic in this quarter.
So right now, not right now, but in the last three quarters, Lennoxville has not won any of the quarters. The last one was the closest quarter that they have. It's a 21-19 score. So they got a plus. St. Foix got a plus two on their lead.
Langille tripped up. Well defended by Gahal. Here come the Dynamic. They have a 4-on-3. Switch of play. And they'll slow down Bergeron. Trail pass, Gahal. She starts the play. And now we'll defer to Kofi. Backdoor, one pass too many. And that is recovered by the Cougars. And here is Captain Oliver the other way. And we'll find Larocq. And here is Sarazin. Up short, rebound by Bay. And he might have to think that they're starting to run out of energy here, the Cougars.
Running out of energy, but also execution right there. Like, Babay had one of her easier shots of the day. Nobody came to double team. She just rushed it a little bit. But next time, definitely that should be going in.
Gagal, back door. And the finish not there for Paradis. And a reminder, there's two spots from Quebec going to Nationals.
Yep.
So if you were to win the next two, and a foul right there by Paradis on Babay, if you were to win today and tomorrow, you're going to Nationals. That's in the case of Dawson St. John, they need one more win, but for Champlain and for St. Foix right now, if they were to win tomorrow, they booked their tickets to lovely Lakeland College.
That's it. That's the goal, right? One more game. The first game is always the hardest one to get there, but that's a lot of pressure for Dawson. Dawson's coming as the top seed. They're going to play Champlain. Both teams definitely want to get to Lakeland, so it's going to be a tough game. There's a lot at stake, right? Literally, figuratively.
Second attempt is good for Babin, who is a 69% free throw shooter. And they're down 65-46. 19-point lead for St. Foy. They are in cruise control, 8:30 away from a semifinal berth against St. Jean. And a rematch from last year's semifinal game at Edouard Montpetit. Kofi called for the walk.
Kofi's kind of surprised. Looking at, well, was that a walk? Yeah, she did take a hop before. Not really the St. Foy's offense. They like that. They like when Kofi goes one-on-one, but not right there. There wasn't really an advantage.
Right now for Champlain-Langsville, it's been a dark day and a cold day. Here's a long-range shot for Sarazet by Langille. Miss, rebound, Guerrard. 8:05 left, and there was a whistle on Langille. A bit of a distress moment for her, and this will go back over to the dynamic.
Well, Langille was just looking back at her like, I didn't really foul. Now she was like, yeah, you did. It was like that non-verbal talk right there, but Langille's a dog. She's going to play hard. It doesn't matter if you're the MVP, I'm going to play you.
And given, Sean, if this is going to be a bigger scoreline than what it is of 19, if you're Eric Segal, when do you start resting some of the big hitters, because you got a big one tomorrow against St. Jean if this does hold up?
Not yet. Maybe not after this shot, but not yet. There's still too much. There's still a lot to play for right
and
now.
And one. Guerrard. She chased it. She hunted it. And she was the coolest player on the court with the finish at the lip of the cup.
No, definitely. So, like you were saying, back to your question, when do you start subbing your players since you're up by 20? Maybe at the five-minute mark, slowly but surely you start subbing some of your top key players. Maybe Niles, you'll come out. Sophie Bergeron will come out also, but gradually you'll take out your top hitters.
And for Coach Cassavy, last year they lost by 8 to the Dawson Blues. And right now they're on the verge of losing to St. Foy on this Friday afternoon. Kung. And that is erratic, and that is recovered by Guerrard, and here come the dynamic. Unfortunately for Lennoxville, they cannot contain the fizz of St. Foy in the bottle. And we go back and forth here.
Mo, what great hands there,
yeah,
Mo.
Of course.
Look at you. You're a baller?
I was about to smash that ball, but I didn't want to hurt Alain with my...
You're a baller, man. I saw
like
you.
Like Dikembe Mutombo, like...
You blocked that one.
With my pen in hand, too.
Wow. You're a professional.
I was trying to protect the pen.
I saw that. You're a professional,
yeah,
there.
I'm trying to protect the pen over here, you know?
So you're leading on the stats right now. You got one block over ahead of me right now.
I do right now. Or one is steal, whatever you want to call it.
It was more a block. You just didn't wag your finger at the end.
Up next will be Vanier against Uduay in the men's semifinal, quarterfinal. And a long three, and that lacked the ingenuity coming from McBain. So we got Vanier, Uduay to open up the men's side of things, and then we'll have at 6 p.m. Brebeuf against John Abbott. And we'll wrap up what started the day, Momo against Champlain.
Some people are saying that may be the game of the day. That Momo, is that a 4-5
matchup? 4-5 matchup, yes. Momo is the four team, so they are the home team in this court. And the shot from Guerrard not there, but we got Uduay against Vanny next. And that is going to be a massive game for Uduay to pull off what would be the biggest upset over the number 2 ranked team in Canada.
Wow, it's going to be tough.
And right now we have one of the top ranked teams in Canada, St. Foy. Them and St. Jean and Dawson, they are all ranked in the top 15 of the CCAA. Two will go, but also Champlain will be a factor in this conversation as well.
Definitely. Liorisacu always performs pretty well. That's why we've been able to have two teams go get the second wild card. So last year,
St. Jean lost in the gold medal game.
But they lost in the gold medal game, but Dawson brought back a bronze. So it's been like the Q is known for being one of the better leagues in the conferences. We haven't won lately the gold medal, but we're always there.
And a finish right there for Studhalter. And she's got great potential to go next level, U Sports.
Definitely, definitely.
At least, if she has NCAA aspirations. St. John lost to VIU in the gold medal game last season. And here is an open shot and deferred by Bergeron. Back out. Delaney with it. Four left in the shot clock. Back door. Ball movements at the death. And that had a deathly end. The ball movement was there, but this still had the right connection of
totally
the degrees.
Agree there. Nice pass, nice pass. Got ball went to the corner, got to the 45. Trompe has hit a couple of those shots already, so you know she could hit that.
So you'll be off the next couple of games. I'll have Frank Renee with me on the bilingual broadcast coming up. Your thoughts, Vanny Udwe,
like, I'm going to go with a favorite, but Udwe has a puncher's chance.
Splash going through. Langille, 25% from three, and now it's 68-51 lead for the Dynamic.
I just love her demeanor. Like, she's no all business, plays tough D, hits some shots.
And you have to imagine how the Cougars might take a couple of high-risk, high-rewards now trying to pressure the St. Foy ball handlers.
They definitely have to at this point. They're down by 17.
Get back in the ricochet. Up in the air. Last touch by St. Foy. And this goes back over to the Dynamic. Angelique Marcoux in the game. So you see Segal really bringing in some of the deeper options that he has of depth.
Now he's back. The MVP's back in. I think they got two starters back in there, Mo. I think he just wants to make sure, even though as a coach you're never safe. You know, you always feel like there could be a comeback. So he's bringing back his starters.
Ooh. Langille thought about the three. Will go option B, and she is fouled. And not a real clean connection on that drive to the rim with 4:59 left in this ballgame.
Langille there. What's up? Langille just makes things happen there. Fighting for a starting position next year, like the way she's playing right now.
Well, you know what? For this Cougar team, and I know this year was a bit unique of the divisional format, but they could have easily had all four teams from that one division in the playoffs. Could have.
Well, let's be honest. It should have been like the CFL, right? The top six teams make it to
a crossover. But
that was the rules. That's what the coaches agreed upon. So we can't.
But in defense of Momo, they almost pulled off the ultimate
smash and grab
sucker punch ending, right? They were a basket away from forcing overtime against Champlain.
Definitely. Any given Fridays.
And that's missed by Langille. That is recovered by Marcoux. And here come the Dynamic the other way. 4:32 left in this first fourth quarter play for three. And that's an incomplete coming through from Trompe. And away comes Langille. Trailing three. Lacking the air quality on that one, and back over it comes to Gerard, the MVP of this league. And she goes by one. Gerard is galloping. Extra pass. One miss. Second shot, no good. Rebounded by the Cougars.
Now that was good ball movement. Now I think it's time. Like, you can see now, Coach Juliana is going to start bringing in players here. That was a foul. Yeah,
and you have to think now, the air resonation is starting to set in for Lenoxville as they bring in some of the backups onto the court.
Yeah, I think Coach Cassidy and Coach Eric Segeller, it's white flag right now. We've got a timeout right now here, Mo.
Timeout called by St. Foy. Stay tuned here. 68-51, St. Foy on their way to a dancing date with St. Jean tomorrow afternoon. Welcome back here to St. Lambert. It is a 68-52 lead. Sean Oliver, Mo Khan here as we get back on air, as we did have a celebrity coming in this matchup.
So we got two MVPs today on the court. We got a former MVP, Chloe Oliver. And we got Nyland Zeus, so we got two MVPs in the house.
Two MVPs. Coy Oliver by way of Davidson University. And Gerard and the women of St. Foy, they know what's the mission here. For this St. Foy Dynamic team, they have not won a Quebec title since 2020 when they beat Dawson at Dawson. And they want to get back to the winning ways of what they were before.
Well, that was right before COVID. You're right, Mo.
Yeah.
Did you do that call also?
I did. I did do that call.
With who? Olga?
Olga Rikak. Yeah, Rikak. Yeah. So right now, we look at it this way. St. Jean, St. Foy tomorrow. Champlain, Dawson. Yeah. We have some heavy. This is the heavyweight fights that we get to have in the first two games tomorrow afternoon.
Yep. The prediction, they're the top four teams in the queue, and it's bared out to fruit, and now we're going to see who's going to take the queue championship. But before we get there, we got two semifinals tomorrow, and it's going to be really interesting to see what's going to happen here. Dawson was able to. Some of their players are here watching the game. I know Trevor might be watching the game, and I know that's
Trevor. He has it figured out. Trevor Williams.
Trevor is a coach of the year, stud as a coach. He's done it many times. We got Wayne Yearwood also coach of the year.
That's right. They had a nice team photo yesterday with the men's and women's.
Yes, they did. But back to he's the GOAT. Like literally, Trevor Williams is the GOAT as coaches. In the queue, he's done it so many years, winning so many banners, sending so many players down to the States. So, Coach, he's the GOAT, man. And as a player, Turbo was amazing.
Absolutely, he was. Actually, funny story with Coach Williams. My mom used to be co-workers with his sister.
No way.
So she knew Trevor Williams. I had no idea.
Okay.
And I was trying to explain to her that Trevor Williams is one of the greatest players in Montreal basketball history. And my mom doesn't follow the sport of basketball as closely. But here comes a chance now for the Dynamic to ice away this game, and they will indeed. Sophie Bergeron as they head over the hills, heading home with the victory, and they will extend their stay by two more days in South Shore, Quebec.
Definitely. There's a gold medal match and a bronze medal match this weekend. But that's amazing. That's a great story there, Mo.
Small world.
It's very small world. Turbo, Olympian.
But here's a funny story, though. My mom goes, well, it's funny because the sister says she's the better basketball player than Trevor Williams.
It's always like that with siblings, right? Timeout. We've got a timeout.
Timeout call. Stay tuned here. 71-53 lead. St. Foy on their way to a semifinal date.
Yeah. Get y'all mushed. Smushed. Yeah. 21. Biggest. Put it in the chicken wing. 21, can you do something for me?
21.
Can you hit a little rich flex for me?
21.
And 21, can you do something for me?
21.
Drop some bars to my ex for me. And 21,
21.
Can you do something for me? Can you talk to the ops next for me?
Okay.
21. Do your thing, 21, do your thing.
21.
Do your thing, 21. Do
yellow
your
diamonds
thing.
In the watch. This costs a lot. Never send a bitch or die. That's how you get shot. IDM in vanish mode, I do that a lot.
Welcome back here. It is Sean Oliver. It is Mo Khan. The narrative of this game was the flying start and fast finish for St. Foy, and they never looked back against Langsville today.
Yep. Once they went up 30-14, if I remember, that 16-point lead, Eric Segal was up. He was praising his players. Great defense. Yeah, they took that lead. And when you're the favorite, you want to get that comfortable lead and just show the underdog, no, this is not going to be the game. It's not going to be like that the game that we had last week.
And here come the Dynamic the other way. So the trajectory for Lennoxville, they'll have to go back to the drawing board and kind of figure out how to get back to this point and overcome the quarterfinal game to get themselves a playoff win under their belts next season.
Definitely, but they've come a long way. Like there's some tough seasons where they didn't have any victories, had not that many, but now the talent base is there. Coach Cassidy is always doing a good job recruiting, so bright future for them also.
No question. They'll host the Provincials next year.
Yep, that's true.
They'll host the Provincials next year, so they would love to be in it.
And we know the fine folks down in Lanksville love their sports, and they'll support it.
Oh, definitely, Mo. They definitely love this ball. Have you ever been in that gym there? What's the McNeil gym?
Mitchell gym.
The Mitchell
they have
gym.
A couple of gyms out there.
Yeah, nice the Mitchell gym. It's hard. Ask Concordia. It's hard to win down there at the Mitchell gym, especially on a Saturday night. Woo!
And it's been a hard day for the Lanksville here at St. Lambert's. It'll be a long hour and a half bus ride back home. A lot of what-ifs, but plenty of hope for the future. And trying to get back to this point next March.
Definitely, definitely. But there's a lot of building blocks, a lot of top players. I'm not sure how many players that they're going to lose, but there's a lot of they have a good talent base, and I think they have a good recruiting class coming in.
I'm curious on what Eric Segal's going to wear tomorrow for Jordans.
Oh, I don't know. I think he's more worried about how he's going to play St. Jean than his Jordans, but it'll be interesting.
I'll be interested by his fashion attire, and Kofi missing that one, and that is going to be a Lanksville ball with 1:22 left. So a game that didn't have the same edge and twitchiness that we saw in game number one.
Yep.
Perhaps for the women's semifinals tomorrow, we'll find out. Stay tuned here. 1:22 left in this ball game. St. Foy up 18.
Young got no one that back calling me splurge. Let me jump right out the curve. Bentley spray fly like a bird. Spin on the first and the third. Solid, I'm keeping my word. Can't be my equal, I don't know what you heard. Crack up the foreign, I swear. Keep me a stick if they purge. Young, I don't want that, they working my nerves. I'm about to pause to serve. Hitting this ball like a purr. Back from the back of a purr. Ice, the bird. Dropping on all you little turds. Can't take the pipe, but you turn. In my own lane, we can't merge. So no hills you can learn. Let's see how much you can earn. Why me go big like the worm? And I ain't smoking no sherm. I'm in the VIP lit. QP, QP ski. All of my bettors is pretty, they showing it.
Welcome back here, Sean Oliver, Mo Khan. A flawless standard set by St. Foy today. And for Lanksville, the end product was lacking early, and it showed how they were deep in the depths of red ink in this matchup.
If I'm Eric Segal, they're the Christmas team I've seen so far. Like, the last game, Champlain and Momo weren't that crisp. Right now, they're playing like it's the beginning of the season here, and they're the sub coming in here.
And now Saramo Jacob about to come in as both teams have more or less emptied out the bench options.
Definitely.
And valuable playing time for the youngsters of Lanksville and St. Paul, because you never know, right? If your number's called, you got to be ready to play, right?
Definitely got to be ready to play. And, you know, some people might view this as garbage time. To me, this is not. This is where you cultivate. This is where you get better. And this is time, like, you're going to get into these big spots. So next year, you're ready for this.
Yeah, without a doubt. Up next, Udwe Vanier. And the free throw going in. And for the Delaney attack dynamic, they are up now 72-53. 108 left in this ball game, and for Champlain Lanksville, their season will come to an end at St. Lambert. And the finish right there from Marlon Pinot, who played 1 minute in the win over St. Foy last week, and now gains some time late in this ball game.
Delaney's just bringing up the ball. They're going to try to. They're going to run their offense here, even though it's not the starter. But Kofi's still in the game right now. Oh,
and that is going to be over. And that will be Cougar ball, 45.7 left.
Even the rest mentally, they seem to be. Oh, there's a sub coming in.
And coming in now will be number 9 in Trempe. So Kofi's day is done. And they will keep the reserves out there with 45.7 left. Tomorrow morning, 11 a.m., Dawson, Champlain, St. Lambert. The Battle of the Blues. And a three going in for Langille. And then tomorrow afternoon at around 1:15, St. Jean, St. Foy, another battle with these two teams and the arts of this matchup, the chess game that we'll have tomorrow afternoon.
Big, big game, big. Oh, crossover.
Coming through the lane is Saramo Jacob right through, and that does not go in. So, Sean, final thoughts here before we get to the player of the games coming up.
Great offensive showing by St. Far right now. They're the crisper team defensively and offensively. For Lenoxville, Katanova had a tough game. The All-Star had a tough game, but it's not all on her shoulders. The great defensive presence by St. Far, double team anytime they had the ball in the post. So, great strategy on St. Far's part.
And
go ahead, Mo.
With that, St. Far, St. Jean, Dawson, Champlain, St. Lambert. An absolute fizzing start for the Dynamic, and they win this game 73-58.
Great game here. We'll get to the players of the game, but that was a great game here on both parts.
And for some of the Cougars playing their last ever game as a member of the Blue and Whites, not the remedy that they want.
Definitely not the remedy that they wanted there. So we'll have a lineup soon to see what the players of the game.
Player of the game's coming up here. And for Eric Segal, he now gets ready for a big one tomorrow against the defending Quebec champions.
Next 24 hours, he's going to be watching that game tape, strategizing what's next.
And for Coach Cassavy, it's going to be a long bus ride, but again, it's going to be a building block for next year to be back here on their home court to prove a point.
Definitely, Mo.
So play of the game's coming up as both teams line up at their stripes. And here we go with the player of the games. Actually, you know I've been doing the player of the games, huh? So I know who's won. If we had like a Vegas lineup, I would have won some money.
You would have won.
Yeah.
You bet big there.
She was the bright light. She was the go-to supply line in the early going. And unfortunately, they neutralized her and didn't have much of an influence in the second half, but she was definitely the bright spot for Lenoxville today.
Definitely, she was her, not the lone star, but she was really bright. She played really well. Yeah, Marie played well.
And they'll take a picture here. We'll get out of it so we don't photobomb it.
But you know what Google, there's that magic thing, that magic eraser.
Of course.
Hopefully it's a Google phone, she's a magic eraser.
The iPhone over there.
It's an iPhone, okay,
So that is it for us here. We have our women's semifinals matchup set up. Champlain, St. Lambert, Dawson tomorrow morning, 11 a.m. And then we have the second half, which is St. Jean, St. Foy, which will be after that game. Up next in an hour's time, Outaouais, Vanier. Sean, we'll speak to you soon, later on tonight. Bye for now.
Bye.
I just signed a deal, I'm on. Yeah, yeah. I go where I want, good, good. Play if you want, it's do it. I'm a young CEO, sure. Yeah, yeah, yeah. The first play on my body in them. I just check my balance, I'll probably pull up to your hood and come buy me a new. No cap. You know that your uncle told you that crazy. Don't think that she lied to you new. Get caught with you when I'm popping them both. Now they hot just like Bobby and Whitney. Ha. Say I'm the GOAT. Act like I don't know. But fuck it, I'm obviously winning. Don't make me go hit the bank. And take out 100 to show you our pockets is different. I'm out with your bitch and I only want knowledge. She got a little mileage, I'm chilling. You disrespect me and I beat you up all in front of your partners and children. I'm the type to let them think that I'm broke until I pop out with a million. And take 20K and put that on your head and make one of your partners come kill you. Yeah. Say fucking with me, then he gotta grow up. Cause then there gotta be kids. This thing can't fit in my pocket. I got it. Like I hit the lottery. I slap the shit out. No talking, I don't like to argue. I don't. Ain't gonna be no more laughing. You see me whip out, cause I'm gonna be the shot mirror. No cap. I don't follow no on IG, but all of your they following. Ha. And that little ain't gonna shoot with that gun. He just pull it out in his pictures. Ha, ha, ha. Packing the mail, it's gone. She like I smell cologne. Yeah. I just signed a deal, I'm on. Yeah, yeah. I go where I want, good, good. Play if you want, it's do it. I'm a young CEO, sure. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ha. Packing the mail, it's gone. She like I smell cologne. Yeah. I just signed a deal, I'm on. Yeah, yeah.
I go where I want, good, good. Play if you want, let's do it. I'm a young CEO, sure. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Talking about that, I'ma pop that. Got like 32,000 in one of my pockets. The other one, that's where the Glock is. You little nigga wanna be in that gangsta, man. Tell all these little niggas, stop that. Be the Burmian in front of the store where your mammy and grandmama shopping. I opped out on a whole nother wave on it. Let's see one of these little top that. I'll return a to a convertible. Push me a little top back. Her boyfriend be hating and calling a groupie just cause she like all my music. She sent me a text and to delete the message. She trying to find out it's confused. I don't know what these niggas thinking about. Use the brain on your head for you losing. I pull up at the school and I teach her some shit. Tell your bro I'm a motherfucking tutor. Remember I used to cheat off a pretty tip. All the teachers, they thought I was stupid. Was expecting a box to pull up on the truck, man. It's pulled up on the scooter. Huh? Packing the mail, it's gone. Yeah. She like I smell cologne. Yeah. I just signed a deal, I'm on. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I go where I want, good, good. Play if you want, let's do it. I'm a young CEO, sure. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Huh? Packing the mail, it's gone. Yeah. She like I smell cologne. Yeah. I just signed a deal, I'm on. Yeah, yeah. I go where I want, good, good. Play if you want, let's do it. I'm a young CEO, sure. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Look, look, I like my red bone, fat, cello, light skin, yellow, iced out, hello. I'm the king of New York, mellow, block here by the Regis and Pello. Ask around, know me, I'm a Euro boy, Ginobili. I like my red bone, fat, cello, light skin, yellow, iced out, hello. I'm the king of New York, mellow, block here by the Regis and Pello. Ask around, know me. Boy, you know me.
I've been so gone. I like red bones. My type, light skin, fat, jello. But be switching sides nowadays on a regular. I never respected it. Money over. I know that's everything. Money over. I know that's high. Rocking BBS by Elliot Weathermans. I won't never ever give in a wedding ring. 45 on my hip. I ain't fighting. I'm chewing on that like a vitamin. Pockets be on E. Something they already know, but I'm dropping the T. They making up rumors and lies. Okay, I'm sick and I'm tired. I'm out of fatigue. None of my be mine. They could have been one of yours, but they out of your league. I'ma just call her Fatima. Now that ain't really her name, but she for the team. I get flies if it's like I looted up. All this money you talking ain't no dust. I'm the king of New York and I'm God. If Pop was alive, it would have been two
I like
of
my
us.
Red bone, flat, cello, light skin, yellow, iced out, hello. I'm the king of New York, mellow. Block here by the Regis and Pello. Ask around, know me. I'm a Euro boy, Ginobili. I like my red bone, flat, cello, light skin, yellow, iced out, hello. I'm the king of New York, mellow. Block here by the Regis and Pello. Ask around, know me. I'm a Euro boy, Ginobili. Pull up like instrument cleaners, acing out Phoenix. I make a movie, sell out arenas. She off the token, Demi Lovato. All of my denims is murder bravado. AP Audemars, where Aquafina. Hitting like Ike, singing like Dina. Dior on my body, sneakers got no creases. They limited, baby, tell me if you see him. My diamonds dancing, paint a face like Marilyn Manson. They roll up that room, run straight from Cali. They get a plate from Sally's. Queen of Blue is trial, they set him up. They matters, you know what I rep, yeah, it's tatted up. You ain't get f- cause you ain't fat enough. If you talk crazy, get batted up. Yeah, I like my red bone, flat, cello, light skin, yellow, iced out, hello. I'm the king of New York, mellow. Black hair by the Regis and Pello. Ask around, know me. I'm a Euro boy, Ginobili. I like my red bone, flat, cello, light skin, yellow, iced out, hello. I'm the king of New York, mellow. Black hair by the Regis and Pello. Ask around, know me. I'm a Euro boy, Ginobili.